mother. Please. Please say something.
Diana.
What? What is it?
You're on my hand.
Just stay calm, I'll dig you out. Your harmonizer's toast, but I gave you mine. There's not much T energy to draw on.
Did it work? Are they safe?
I think so. Kaven gave them cover. If they stick to the plan, they should be miles deep before NEVEC punches through.
Good, good. You need to be gone when they do.
Fat chance, old man. You're my only family, and I'm not leaving you in here. Damn it, McGinnis, move this thing.
You're as stubborn as your grandmother.
This is all my fault. I just listened to you.
No, you were right. I deserved every word.
No, just forget about that, please. It doesn't matter.
It does. When you've been keeping secrets so long, it's hard to stop. There are things you have a right to know.
We'll have time later.
Stop.
Come on. Damn it.
Damn. You know, back on Earth, my father believed you had to confess your sins if you want to be forgiven. He never got the chance, but maybe this is mine.
The Earth was a troubled place when I left it. I was 32 when they recruited me. A bold and lucrative opportunity to be part of an expedition to an unexplored world. 50 years ago now. 50 years of living with the consequences of my choices. 50 years since I damned us all.
We were blown by the storm. However, it appears the transponder guiding our welcoming party to this location was lost in the crash. Without that, our odds of survival are remote. I suggest we find it.
Stay here while I track it down.
Alone out here.
transponder. Let's get some light in here.
Place you look.
Dr. Kendrick Kovach. Don't call me Kenny.
Hey, my name's Hutchings. Friend of Frenchman's LaRoche. So, you're not packing a long-range firearm, are you?
Not on me. But somewhere in that ship, I got a 30-06 old family heirloom. No idea where it's packed. Got my pistol, though.
Good enough. Give me a second.
I'm going to retire to the relative safety of the interior. Good luck up here.
Lucky you made it down in one piece. That storm came out of nowhere. Dr. Roman insists your entry corridor was clear, so who knows what that was about.
She's been wrong about a lot of things lately. Oh, what magnificent specimens. Please, kill them.
So this is what the recruiter meant by non-aggressive indigenous creatures.
Oh, buddy, you're gonna learn to take things NEVEC tells you with a grain of salt. In fact, some days you might need a bucket of the stuff.
You sound like Diaz.
Hey, say what you will. She raised some valid questions.
Yeah, sure. You mean she blathered insane conspiracy theories every time you're trying to drink in peace? Why even work for a company if you accuse it of such things?
Who's this Diaz? Sounds like a character.
She's the one you're replacing. A contractor like you and I. Until she disappeared.
Man, this supply drop couldn't have come sooner.
We, the very stale. And also the pornography.
I bet Braddock's gonna... Oh, son of a bitch!
What's happening up there? Have you been killed?
No, I made it in one piece somehow. What now?
Your environment suit is within a vehicle range of my reach. You should be seeing extra tactical readouts. Minimap, radar, loadout details, as long as you stay close to the rig. Tu me comprends?
Good deal.
Use your radar to see advancing enemies. Look now! Hey, newbie, pick up the growing orange blood the animals leave behind. You will need it for later, and fast.
I see the problem. Give me a second.
Newbie, know how to repair? First, you have to find the proper repair frequency.
Yep, thanks, boss. I know what I'm doing here.
Do it yourself. Huh.
Okay, you're all set.
Heads up. You got incoming.
The trip to base camp was uneventful, but the calm didn't last for long.
Look, you weren't her only friend on this base. We all miss Diaz.
But I tried to warn you. NEVEC would never use that as an excuse until they started seeing results.
It's not about Jeanette. You know it's not.
Oh, so you're still blaming me, though?
I never said that.
You didn't have to. You just checked out.
They're looking for something that doesn't exist. I'm directing my efforts where the science leads. That used to matter to you.
It still does, Bonnie, but this isn't my call. NEVEC is footing the bill for this operation. They insisted.
And that's it. Not a peep from you.
Not a... It's only because of me that you still even have a job here.
Oh, yes, a job answering to... Him.
Dr. Kovac, glad to see you made it in one piece.
Yes, it's been an eventful morning. Phil Braddock, I presume?
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Roman? Been some time.
Feels like yesterday, Kenny. You'll excuse me.
Okay.
And you must be Jim Peyton. Here, you really stepped up out there. You must have a million questions. I hope you don't mind being thrown into the deep end.
Sir, I'm here to work. All I need to know is how a man can earn some credits around here.
Thermal energy. That's the name of the game.
Akrid blood? Hate to tell you, boss, we just spilled gallons of the stuff.
Oh, it's well more than that. Flows through everything on E.D.N. 3. Creatures, tectonics, all the way down to the core. Makes life possible in a climate like this. No other substance like it in the universe.
And NEVEC believes this can solve the energy crisis on Earth.
Oh, I believe it can. We're here to study it. Find a way to make it viable, cost-effective for harvest and export. We are leaving no angle unexplored.
Very good. Science is always best, without boundaries.
Peyton and I got a lot of contracts that keep you busy. Construction, repairs on the base, but... If you want to go home a rich man, you'll take on that hazard pay. Keep us supplied with this stuff.
Yes, sir.
Just point me to my rig.
Peyton, I can't recommend strongly enough that you visit the quartermaster and get yourself a good hunting knife. You've seen how up close and personal the Akrid can get. But first you want to head down to the service pit and inquire with our lead tech, Gale, as to the status of your rig. Welcome aboard, Jim. Doctor, if you'll stay and chat. Sorry you had to see that. You know Bonnie can have a flair for the dramatic.
Is that what that was? I assumed it was sarcasm. Usually she just yells at me.
Yeah, well, circumstances are a little different now. I'm sure she'll be a cooperative and productive member of your team. Just a second, Doctor. Jay, any word from LaRoche?
Not yet, sir. He's not responding to any of our calls.
All right, keep me posted.
Actual, this is Campbell. I'm in distribution with Ermolev. The East Block pipes are frozen over again.
Damn it. We just thawed those. All right, get a Gabi over there with the space heaters.
That's the problem, sir. He's already thawing condensers at Coronis. Should I pull him off of that?
No. Okay, look, make an announcement. Let everyone know we're down to a trickle for now. But contact Gabi and tell him to hurry up. You got it?
Roger that. Campbell out.
Peyton, what are you standing around for? Take that elevator down to see Gale and get yourself squared away.
Survival tip number 3. Don't stray from warm areas without an environment suit. Your NEVEC designed suit will keep you warm and safe in even the most inhospitable environments. be mindful to charge your suit overnight and stay within range of an umbilical field at all times. Stay happy, stay warm.
Cold enough for you? It's never cold enough for Crazy Neil. Ice in me veins. Back home, I used to spend summers at McMurdo Base in Antarctica. Long family tradition. My great-great-great-great-grandfather took part in Operation Deep Freeze, and my great-great-great-great-grandmother was a penguin. Now that's a joke, son. You understand? I want to be clear. There ain't nothing funny about sexing a penguin. Not even if they're begging for it. Yeah, cute little bastards, but temperamental. Kind of bitchy, matter of fact, but say what you will about them, they hardly ever try to eat your head. You know not to eat the snow, right?
Turbines in the South Valley are frozen over again. Can someone let LaRoche know? He's neglecting his comm unit. Shocker.
NEVEC survival tip number 6. Never stray from your umbilical in sub-zero temperatures. The umbilical field provides supplemental power to your environment suit, increasing your level of warmth and powering tactical readouts that your suit's battery could otherwise not support. Stay smart. Stay close.
Changes to your medical plan will be covered in this afternoon's orientation. If you're not currently covered by NEVEC insurance, you are not required to attend.
Dismantling of the Coronis ship aft engine panel for hoisting up to Delta Station for expansion later this week. So watch for falling ice along flight paths 12 and 6.
NEVEC survival tip number 2. Heat hazard warnings. All NEVEC-approved vehicles and utility rigs are equipped with hazard sensors designed to keep you aware of potential dangers in the environment. Do not consider these warnings advice. Consider them gospel. Stay aware. Stay alive.
Watch your falling eyes along flight paths 12 and 6.
I know everyone's excited about the supply drop, but no crowding this time. I see anyone near the inventory out of turn. I'm docking his next paycheck for time lost.
You'll have to forgive my brother. He's not a morning person, and it's been morning here for 3 months.
My brother, he always do watch. Always joke. Norm.
Anyway, welcome to Coronis. We're a skeleton crew right now, but that'll change as soon as we can prove T-Energy's a cost-effective power source. Oh, and if you ever need toilet paper, I'm your man. TP is like gold around here. You remember that.
Thanks. You take care.
I kill Hawk right now. I'm telling you, he'll kill with an Hawk.
Survival tip number 5. Don't eat the snow. On a frontier world, never ingest snow, no matter how thirsty you feel. It can cool your body's internal temperature, causing arterial constriction and organ shutdown. Don't be a test case in the discovery of new diseases. Alien parasite ingestion is also a genuine danger. Stay smart. Stay hydrated.
Welcome to EDN3, Jim. The E stands for extreme. Still working on the rest.
That's great, kid. You want to point me in the direction of your boss?
Oh, Mr. Braddock? I think you'd have seen him already, but... Yeah.
No, I mean the lead tech for this bay. I think they said her name was Gail.
Oh, right. Yeah. That's kind of me. I know. I hear it all the time. Girl's name. Shouldn't I be off looking for a date for junior prom? Dude, I understand you're concerned. Don't worry about a thing. I am totally getting college credit for this gig. I'm kidding. Not in the mood, I read you.
Listen, kid. Gail.
How about we do the get-to-know-yous while we work on putting my rig together?
Ooh, hey, you serious?
Yeah. It was shipped ahead in pieces. Now that I'm here, we can build it.
The thing is, I kind of put it together last week.
Come again?
It's a nice solid rig you got. Pretty intuitive design. It was no trouble. I had fun with it, really. All the diagnostics checked out. In fact, I just got done with the finishing touches.
What finishing touches?
Threw on some spring-loaded Coronis retractors. Jeanette said they always came in handy when the heat was on, which happens more often than you'd think on an ice planet. Get it? Ice planet, because the heat...
Kid, listen to me and listen close. I got three things in the world. My wife, my son, and this rig. Guess which one I'm counting on to take care of the other two? You follow? That is my whole nest egg. I built it myself. I know every gear, every circuit, and I can't have her breaking down on me because some intern needed to show off.
Can I just say two quick things?
Please.
Okay, first, you can't really say in the world anymore because you're on another planet. Sorry, just pet peeve. And secondly? Okay, it's your show, Jim. I'm just here to help out. Give it a test drive whenever you feel like it, and if it ain't ship shape, break it all down by morning. Deal? I promise you won't be sorry.
Let go of my hand.
Okay.
Your rig's up in your bay. I'll meet you up there whenever you wander up.
Take your time.
Jim Peyton, please report to the quartermaster in the basement level. Jim Peyton to the quartermaster.
Seized this morning by the divine spirit of artistic creation. I was at breakfast and Colbeck had come up with these griddle cakes made out of vital wheat gluten or something, and it got me thinking about the corn my folks used to grow when they still had their farm on Olympus 1. And I was saying how I couldn't have been more than 10, but I built this thing called a cornipole, but it's really more of a slingshot. And then I realized nobody was at the table anymore, so I came out here and I installed some Coronis retractors on the new guy's rig. It's like a human cornipole, see? Except, you know, kinda not. Hope you don't mind. I should get some coffee. Or sleep. Yeah, sleep's good. Yeah, coffee's better.
I heard the whole hangar jawing about how we were getting a fresh pair of faces around here. I'm the quartermaster, name's Bowers, but most people call me Birdie. You make an honest dollar, you come spend it here, eh? All right, pal, take your time eyeballing the wares. I'll stay out of your hair. Quality hunting knife. Top of the line for up-close protection. Comes with a lifetime guarantee and unlimited free sharpening. Not that you'll need it. Nice. She'll pack a bigger punch now, though the trade-off's a touch more recoil. It's well worth it, in my humble opinion. Come back anytime, eh?
Yeah. Nice meeting you, Birdie.
Jim's heading out, so let's prep the rig, people! This though. Oh, you ready to try this? Dry treated hypertensile kern retractors. I like to call it the cockpit express. You got one on the front, one on the back. You just clip in, give the line a tug, shoot.
And by shoot, you mean launch myself up at solid metal from 10 meters down and hope I don't break my neck?
As an alternative to being eaten? Yeah.
Diagnostics check, but let's see if those servo controllers are working like you remember them. Go ahead, test out that claw arm. Great! Now test the drill arm swing servos with a punch. Wow. Really?
Watch it, kid.
Excellent. Notice how much faster your arm's swinging? Just a little gift from yours truly. Okay, just a few more tests. Now the drill. Lastly, I upgraded the shielding on your rig's bracers to class 4. Try a defensive posture. Beautiful! You'll be using that move here on EDN3 more than you have probably on any other job. Sweet, we're done. Let's release your rig. Be free!
LaRoche, come in. Coronis base to LaRoche, do you copy? God damn it, we can't lose LaRoche now. We barely have Diaz replaced.
Hey, Chief. Jim Peyton here. You copy?
Peyton, is your rig online already?
Yeah, looks like the kid here might know his stuff, but I'll know for sure after I take her out for a spin. That French fella still not back?
Yes, I'm afraid he hasn't been responding to radio calls.
Well, why don't I go have a look for him? I know where we parted ways, and he did save our butts just a little.
Say no more, Peyton. You've got your first assignment. Good luck.
Hey, fellas. You want to take the elevator up to Delta Station? You need clearance first. You guys are absolutely getting on my last nerve.